Marvel Machine X, meaningless monstrosity or magical music instrument? Let's try to find out. Okay. On this board, there are 38 pieces of tape, which represents the 38 mechanical channels on the Marble Machine X. We have 19 instruments. We drop marbles from two positions on each instrument, so 19 times 2 equals. The reason 38 is a magic number is because it's larger than what it sounds like. Basically, it's larger than life. So many times during this process, I've come up against a task that I have to repeat 38 times. And today is one of those days. Last week, I bent these two PMMA pipes for the first channel of the marble drop of the first note of the vibraphone. And today, I need to fill out all 38 pipes. I've already bent the 6 drum pipes. Both Marius and me have tried this before. We have filled this with pipes. He spent 3 days, I spent 3 days trying to do this. So this is even third time's the charm taking on this super daunting project. For every pipe I finish, I will remove one piece of tape and we can keep a day count and a time count here to actually visualize how long time 38 takes.
Don't boil your heads, both of you, said Hagrid. You're a wizard. I'm a what? Gasped Harry. A wizard, of course.
So you've seen me working on this for 3 days straight. Look at the difference on the machine. You don't see any difference. This happens so many times. I spend a lot of days, a lot of time working on the machine and you don't even see it because it just disappears in between all the 10,000 parts. Although when we look closer, we can see some changes. Up here, we can see the 22 finished vibraphone pipes. They will all feed the marbles. The marbles come out here. If I go around, we can also see the 8 bass pipes here. Channel 1, channel 2, channel 3,
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Last one, 22. Perfect. So here's the two groups for the bass guitar. These two channels are for the thickest string. So channel 31. 32.
Bass string. 33. 34. 35. 36.
And 37. Last channel of the Marble Machine X. 38. Two channels for the cymbal. This metal connection here is an improvisation I made during this pipe bending project. Okay, we're in the middle of day 2. These two pipes here is for the cymbal. They are a little bit special. At the very bottom of the machine, you can see the cymbal far down below. And I need the same dropping distance from every marble drop to its instrument, which means that the cymbal marble drop is going to have to be much lower. Since this is a module and this is another module, I need a marble transportation for the cymbal marbles with a split. So this pipe is loose and you can remove it for the transportation and then disconnect the two modules. So I'm gonna be a little inspired by Frank Howard in how I put this together. I'm gonna make it oversized and cut everything clean. When I have welding inspiration, I never have fresh, good tungsten tips. The best trick ever that I learned from Marius, I think, is that when you grind your tungsten, you can grind both sides. Starting with TIG Weld, I only made a tip on one side, but what's genius is when you get this side contaminated, you don't have to run down to your grinder, you just flip it 180 and you have a new tip. Genius. And there you go. So now I'm just going to fill this whole thing with weld. That's flat enough. I have to say that the more I use a tap handle, the less I want to do this with the cordless. For everyone who has been following that story arc. Okay, so we're finally coming to the Frank Howarth inspiration. You see that this end doesn't look really good, but I made this oversized so I can cut off the end clean and have a nice look. So now I want to split this in the middle, but as you can see, this fence is way too short to hold it. Use a sacrificial piece like that, and then another sacrificial piece. This all looks a little sketchy, but I actually think this is safe. So now I have two pairs of binoculars, all with cut clean edges. First I was going to weld this straight onto this, but that looked a little bit plump, so I made this extra leg here to turn this little thing into a little feature. Yay! Reward. This is the example docking pipe, and as you can see here, we have two pipes here, the two symbol pipes, and obviously this dock comes on like so. So it's just a lock to connect the pipes and go further down to hit the symbol. And again, I need to split these pipes since this is one module and that is another module. So I need to take them apart for transportation. And this is a great example of how much extra features I need to design into this machine to be able to take the modules apart. I also love that it looks floating and that it catches the angle from these matrix sentinels. Sweet! The real complexity in this project was to find space for everything. Every other pipe is above and every other below, like a weave. So to get one of these pipes in place were never an issue. It was to get all 38 pipes next to each other in place. That was the real issue. My silicon rod is stuck inside here because my string snapped. If I can't pull it out, this whole piece has to be scrapped. Yes.
5 points from Gryffindor.
So the marble divider works and the marble distribution system that I just built works. So now actually the thing that is left is the vibraphone, the resonator pipes on the vibraphone, the dropping points for the vibraphone, the bass, the dropping points for the bass, funnels. And then we're pretty much there. All the audio, electronics, it's a lot. Kinetic fingers, we'll see what happens with those. But I can actually list it pretty quickly, verbally anyway. The tough thing with this machine is that, like, before I had doubts in the process, I had doubts if it was going to work or not. And when the drums worked, I don't have those doubts anymore. Now my doubt is if it's a good idea or not. Why don't I just use normal music instruments? So that's a much like more difficult kind of doubt. That problem is like unsolvable if the idea is stupid. So yeah, that's kind of crazy feeling. I would like to say a huge thanks for all the support you gave me when I put out the video of taking a break. I didn't even dare to read the comments because I felt like I was cheating. And then I was hiking in the forest with Hannes. He read this one comment to me and I was really touched by this. So I just wanted to read this for you. So in that video, I mentioned that I've only been showing you half of the process lately. So during the spring, I mostly showed you building. I didn't talk at all about how I was feeling in the process. Back to this comment. I was in the forest of Sweden with Hannes. Everything was so beautiful. We were walking like 25 kilometers through Hobbit. Like it looked like everything looks like the Shire. Suddenly Hannes says, Martin, I know you're scared of the reactions on your video saying that you were going to take vacation, but I've read the comments. Do you want to hear it? And I was like, Hannes, you already got this ball rolling. Now you have to finish, of course. Tell me. And he said, Martin, it was so good. You had so much support. And Hannes in the forest showed me this comment. And I'm gonna let this comment speak for you all. The comment is from Cinnamuno Smiles. Here we go. I know this probably won't ever get seen with so many other comments, but I agree that leaving out your emotional reactions to things is a mistake when making these videos. Part of the charm of these videos is not only the fantastic complexity and precision of the MMX and its design and construction, but also seeing how jolly difficult it all is. When we see your frustration in a video, it's not a sign of weakness, it's a testament to the massive amount of work that goes into building the MMX. Achievement is nothing without difficulty. If we only see the positive side of your achievements in your videos, we cannot see the scope of the processes that led to this point. And we only get the impression that all this work has been smooth and easy. This series, in my opinion, is not a tutorial on how to build an MMX at home in 100,000 easy steps. Rather, it's a journey of Martin and his friends against the mountain that is the MMX. If you stumble on the mountain, let us stumble with you. In any case, I'm glad you're finally taking a well-deserved break and we look forward to your return. One day, I hope to become a great engineer like you. Thank you, Martin, for everything. If you stumble on the mountain, let us stumble with you. Thank you, Cinnamuno Smiles, for taking your time to write this. It did get seen and it did get felt. Autumn 2019 is gonna be a roller coaster and I'm gonna take you along for this ride. This is usually a sign that it's bedtime for me. Without further ado, thanks for watching and see you on the next Meet the Gods on Wednesday. Thank you.